Hello guys and welcome to a video about me talking from 1.4. This background I'm using this now. This is a screenshot from our build I made there with from the game together with a person from Steam, and we have all the artifacts here. By the way, you thought he was cheating because of the Brain of Cthulhu. Well, I got some red solution and the summon for the brain, because I would say it doesn't really matter. I mostly did it for the artifact. I thought this was the idea behind it. And yeah, so that's why we have the artifact there. And yeah, I have music. I put the link of the video I'm using there in the title and in the description. And yeah, it's a soundtrack, it's a Windy Day soundtrack, and I really liked it one when it played. And yeah, so what do I think about 1.4? Well, I talk about master mode first. And yeah, so let's begin. I started playing Shellshock. I played Shellshock with someone on Steam I know, and he invited someone new. And yeah, he also played Terraria modded. And so we went together and started up together in 1.4 master modes. Well, I'm personally, I kind of like master mode, and at the same time I don't. It's challenging, sure, that's what it's supposed to be, and you have some unique drops. The drops are mostly just mounts or pets, or you like you see there those relics, like just a golden statue. Okay, you don't see that it's golden because of the Stardust Pillar effect, but I'm sure you also already saw it. Well, what's a bit sad, but I thought was not that nice at the beginning, is that the bosses are the same. They have just more damage and more HP, and they're literally the same. For some bosses I'm not sure, because some bosses seem to have some new attack things like two fish from. But well, I'm okay with this. I mean, modding people will make the bosses new, will make modded more attack patterns. So I think when people start playing modded, it won't hurt anyone that the bosses don't have new attack patterns in the 1.4 master modes. And yeah, I think master mode is more, I think it's more supposed to make the overall gameplay harder, not only the bosses, because well, the bosses were hard, but doable, still the same. But that's what I really noticed, that the enemies, they are really a challenge too. So really quickly got Slime King down, and Eye of Cthulhu wasn't really a problem too. Sure, it's not that hard when you have some boots and a double jump. Mostly a sandstorm, but we didn't have. And yeah, then the first really problematic boss went there, that was just the Eater of Worlds. I think we failed twice there, but yeah. Kinda happy we did, but at the same time, well, could have done better, but whatever, we did it finally. And yeah, he gave really gave us trouble. His projectiles really did damage, and we had to improve the arena a bit to make it work. But at the end we did it. Brain, by the way, we did at the end with max weapon. Mostly I just slayed one for the artifact. MB Queen, we did a first try, but we used most of the time used nurse housing nearby spawn point, But whatever, it's still challenging, because when the boss mostly hits the nurse once or twice, the nurse is gone. And your spawn point, because for multiplayer we did not always had wormhole potions. It was a long fight, but we managed to do it and were kinda happy about it and farmed some V-nades for the wall of flesh later. Skeleton was quite a challenge there. Failed it often because of my fault, because I forgot to set a spawn or failed something or whatever. But at the end we managed to do it. And then the only thing I really did not like at from the 1.4 is the new dungeon. Don't get me wrong, it's kinda cool that you find the way through that labyrinth of broken bricks and also trap rooms. Trap ways when you go down there are just spikes that kill you or try to kill you. Also, I kinda like that you get the bleeding effect for 25 seconds when you hit this. It's like I like it, but at the same time I don't like it because it's annoying, but makes sense. Kinda. Well, they made the wall of flesh also for the dungeon. The dungeon was one of the most annoying things for me in the whole playthrough, because the enemies are strong in there, really really strong. It gets really extreme in hard mode, in the hard mode dungeon after Plantera, but for that later. Well, then we had to defeat the Wall of Flesh, and I think we failed twice if I remember correctly, but we managed to do it. And yeah, we're happy that we're in hard mode at the same, and at the other day then the pirates spawned and completely wrecked us. We had to completely modify our base to defend ourselves from the pirates, and we made the meteor staff that really worked well at the end against the pirate ship. I forgot the name. Well, it took a while and many deaths, but yeah, at the end we managed to do it, and that worked out. Then we fought the destroyer. I think the destroyer first, after farming a bit of stuff. It was not easy and free, but kind of for real, it was the hardest boss of the three mech bosses there. Normally it's one of the easiest, but the probes really did damage. The destroyer himself shoot a lot of lasers, and the probes have many HP. But then we managed to do it, and after that I thought, well, 1.4 has new bosses. So we farmed the summon for the Queen's Diamond, the Queen Slime, and she was really, really, really challenging. Because of the mass enemies she spawns that just spam projectiles, that was a bit annoying. That's a thing I don't like it from the fight. Because she spawns like little slimes that shoot projectiles in every direction that do a lot of damage, and she self jumps around, and well, I didn't manage to do it, and I used the armor then for quite a while, I think, until Plantera, before Plantera, until I made Hallowed Armor. That's cool, it was a cool armor set. It's definitely not the worst one. We sadly did not get, by the way, Titanium to test out the new Titanium set bonus, but well, it worked too. Twins were really not a problem. I think we failed once, and Skeleton Prime was surprisingly easy. Well, then we did Plantera, and we made a big arena there, and I already forgot. It's only a few days old, the story, but I already forgot a bit. I think we did Plantera first try. Not sure about it. And the thing about Plantera is she's not that extreme. Her damage is extreme, and in the second phase, it's even harder when she's super fast moving. But we managed to do it and got to the temple then. And yeah, I forgot what we did before the temple. We did not, we tried out the Frost Moon later. We did the Golem first, I think. I forgot this. I'm sorry, I forgot. The problem is we had a really small Golem arena, but we were lucky and the and a trick with Actros and Virus still worked to make the room there bigger, and we managed to beat Golem then. It was not really much harder, but well, he did a lot of damage too, and we did with it. And then we did Fish Run. I think we first tried the Frost Moon to get him a Jengan because he was ranger and I was melee after Plantera or before Plantera. And we tried to get him a Jengan and we just noticed that it's extremely hard to get something there when you don't have really strong stuff, because the monsters, mostly the enemies there, the small enemies are extremely tanky. The bosses are, well, you can kill them, it's like there are mini bosses and this, they are supposed to tank a bit, but the enemies still tanked a lot of damage too. Same as the hard mode dungeon then. It was like one of the most annoying parts for me to go in the hard mode dungeon and farm for ninja gear or farm items there. And well, I think that's my least favorite part in the playthrough then, because the enemies had a lot of HP. Really took a while to kill them. Also, they do a lot of damage. I think snipers did 350 damage with 70 defense to me. So definitely not a joke, those guys. And was really annoying to farm stuff in there. Mostly because the wizards, mostly the enemies glitched through the ground. I think this is because of my internet connection, but not sure about that. But yeah, the wizards still, yeah, you know, hard mode dungeon. Then what did we do then? I forgot. We did Fish Run, and well, Fish Run was not really a challenge when you know what he does. I mean, it's Fish Run. You know its attack patterns and you can dodge them with dashing or frog leg or something movement speed. You need just movement speed and need to outrun him and attack him. Better a homing weapon. Second phase, not much harder. You can maneuver the Sharknado spawners to the side of the arena to keep room for moving. Last phase was where I was a bit confused. I don't know if it's new because I looked at the map and he moved somewhere else. I'm not sure if this is multiplayer thing or if this is his new attacks, because on the map he moved somewhere completely else, and I think this is creates some kind of confusing map clone that moves around and himself moves somewhere else. But we managed to get this done, and yeah, it took a really long time to farm Fish Run Wings then for me. He got them pretty fast, but I had to wait a bit. I think we killed over 25 Fish Runs until I got mine, but yeah, we got them. Let me see, recording still working. Yep. Then yeah, we tried Empress of Light because it's a post-Plantera boss, and was an instant nope. Her damage was way too insane for us. Our weapons were not even strong enough to do really good damage, and well, we waited until until the cultists, until we tried again and beat her then. And this is a really hard fight. I know it's possible if you can dodge this. It's my really favorite boss in a 1.4, and one of my favorite bosses in Terraria, because it looks really awesome, the colors are nice, the attacks also look really nice. And yeah, it's a tough fight, but it's a really cool fight. And the first time also where I managed to find natural spawns of the summoners for her, because I tried to farm the summon before and did not get it. I ended up just watching it myself, the boss, by cheating it in. Well, it's not the nicest way to do it, but I just wanted to see it. And my first plans were to keep playing 1.3 modded, and well, it was my first time literally getting this item, and it was really cool and felt really good. It was not really that rare. Well, then we also tried out the Old One's army then, and holy Jesus Christ, I wanna see someone who can beat this post-cultist. Like, once you get beat the golem, the way you're supposed to fight it, where the event is at tier 3. Also beat the Martians then, and Martians were also real annoying. It's the kind of thing I meant in Master Modes, that enemies get like tons of HP and they tank literally everything, so one enemy feels like a mini boss. A small mini boss that you have to shoot a few times, that you have to shoot like 5 seconds until it dies. That was the thing that annoyed me a bit the most, because it's harder, they do more damage, they tank more, but that's the thing I really did not like at master mode, because everything seemed to tank like infinitely much damage. And yeah, we failed at round 2 of 7 and Old One's army, because the enemies were just too tanky, did just too much damage, and we had no chance to do anything. Okay, we had no of the defense items from the Tavern Keeper, but still, I don't know how you're supposed to do it. Because our Betsy had 110k HP at the end, and when we finally managed to do it. And yeah, so Martians the same, they were really tanky. The annoying thing for me was that the shield guys, that their hitbox for damaging was always going somewhere else. That's just a multiplayer thing, but that was hella annoying. And they're really, really tanky, they did really a lot of damage, and we had a hard time to kill those Martians also, because of the new laser effect too, because we cannot hide anywhere, and also because of a spam of those enemies that just shoot up from somewhere under us while we try to attack the Martians also. But at the end we managed to do it, and I think we got a few items, not something extremely useful, but still, it was a hard challenge. Then we did cool Lieutenant the cultist, and he was kinda easy again, like he always was most of the time. Well, someone is, I mean, I got with a mod now who makes him impossible hard. No, okay. He was really easy then. We had some fish run gear, we had some other cool webs and stuff, and he was really not that hard. The pillars, I already tried the pillars in Master Mode, and they were really, really annoying then, and it was kind of the same, because the enemies there just tanked a huge amount of damage. You can sit there with your Razorblade Typhoon and attack them, and it will take a while until enemies dies. But that is still, we ended it, man. Well, still at the end we managed to do this. Also, I refarmed the weapons there and did something else. I kinda forgot what we did. I really forgot what you did there. We did not instantly do the moonlight, I think. Well, let's say, let's go to the moonlight fight. Then we farmed, if we did something, I think, yeah, we did the Empress of Light then. We got this, I got my solar stuff, you got this vortex stuff to get a vortex beater, and I got my solar eruption and daybreak. And we managed to do the Empress of Light. We sadly got only the mage and summon weapons. I even got the rare mage weapon. I think we still not got the, we still did not got the other two weapons. But you got some prismatic dye there and used it, and I like the new dyes in 1.4. They're kinda cool. Also the way how to get them. Well, that's a nice way to do it. And yeah, we also got the expert item, which I still like a lot. I think it's a definitely item I will use every time I get it. It's jump speed increase and infinite flight, and who doesn't want infinite flight? And also jump speed and flight speed is always nice. And yeah, then we did Moonlord, and our first array was like, he had a tactic, and I was surprised it kind of worked. While he was waiting, before we both died at the same time, he was waiting at the spawn with the nerds and was ready to run away if I died. The thing is, I did not really die in our first attempt. The thing is, the hitboxes of the Moonlight Eyes of the Moonlight Eyes were keep moving somewhere else than they should be. And so it was kinda impossible for me to hit. The most damage came from my Stardust Dragon, but we ended up dying because I told him to get my Flyrun, and then I died and he died because he could not get up the platform, I think. But well, it was kinda okay for me because it was kinda impossible for me to do damage when the hitboxes are just somewhere randomly in the sky. And yeah. But in the end, we managed to do it. We got pretty lucky with the first few drops. And yeah. So I started to make a chest before to get the items for the Zenith, the end, really endgame sword, like the best weapon in the game now. And well, we found this mostly of the things we farmed, and one thing I had to cheat in, because I searched for the solar eruption for enchanted sword shrines. I think I should now look, at Google if they still exist, because I could not find anything. I walked through the complete world, and yeah, there was no enchanted sword shrine I could find. So I ended up getting it from my vaults. And well, then we made a zenith, farmed the Moonlord a few more times then, and worked really out. He got his celebration MK2 and the SDMG, and I did not get the Terrarian, but I managed to get the swords that I needed. Then we farmed the Pumpkin Moon, worked really well. When I got my zeniths, it really went up damage, because zenith is just a, because this world is just overpowered. And the bosses started to drop relics, so I got on Google and looked up all the relics, so I'm sure we don't miss one. And yeah, at the end I got my zenith after a bit harder time with the events. Then he wanted to get the Zenith too, and we found another one. And well, took up a few tries with Moonlord to die. At the end I got Terrarian too, but I did not need the yo-yo at the end there. We also tried out then. The first moon. It was a surprising thing for him when I just summoned in the first moon, I think. But I just did it because of the start of the night and for the three. You see here the three relics from those bosses there. Really did great there. Was not too hard. And yeah. So that's mostly our adventure there. As I said, the most annoying thing is that the enemies just tank insanely much damage, and if you wanna farm something from an enemy, you really had the hard job of it. I'm kinda okay with it. I don't really wanna play Master Mode so quick again. I did not hate it, but some things were just really annoying to do, but well, that's just a thing you need to handle. And yeah, at the end we did all one's army too, with two Zeniths. It was, of course, completely easy. I think I could just send AFK. I really did for the first few waves. I just put a rock on my mouse and went AFK for the first few waves. Because you could just shred everything that came through the portal. And yeah, that's really it. We beat it, we got the relics, then I made the build there and we put the relics all there. And yeah, I kinda tried to make a good look there with the you see the Stardust pillar or the fog there, just made with fog machines. Look, I kinda like the new items there. Not also the weapons or bosses. I always also like the new blocks there you get, or the new design of the Sunblade blocks. If you didn't see it for yourself, you really need to go. I really like the new Sunblade design. They look really awesome. And yeah, also the fog machine, or they put in a blood moon monolith that you can make your world look like a blood moon. What's really amazing. Also same with the void thing, with the void design from the Moonlord. And yeah, so that's kind of our adventure from 1.4 Master Mode. Kind of really happy to play it with him. Because I wanted to play it alone first, but now I kinda don't want to, because it's kinda annoying hard at some points, but well, I think I stay for now with Vengeance Mode from Calamity. But we'll see, maybe I get better, maybe I wanna I think that I really want to see is someone trying to beat Master Mode in hard with a hard mode character. I think there was already a few persons, I think, that beat it in expert, that beat expert mode in with a hard mode character, and I kind of want to see someone doing this in hard mode in Master Mode. I think it's definitely not impossible, because the game is made to get through it. Theoretically you can go through it flawless with 1 HP without dying, but I would say no one is trying to do that ever in the next 500 years. So yeah, also the other things, like that was my 1.4 adventure. And now I want to talk about the other items, like Dinner of Swords weapons. Like Zenith, it's a really cool spot. I like the animation, the crafting recipe combines a lot of powerful swords, mostly the copper short sword, the most powerful of all the swords. And yeah, so kind of like the crafting recipe. It's powerful, this word, but it's hard to make. You cannot just make it with Luminite and some things. You really need to farm for it. Also, the new golf mechanic. I tried it out. I did not really play the golf map or made a golf map, but I played a bit around with it, and I really like it. Also, like new items like the fog machine you see there in picture. See the fog there? That's from fog machines. Also, like the graveyard biome. Really liking this one. Kinda disappointed about the new ocean thing, because sometimes the ocean goes in a small cave down. I'm a bit disappointed that it's not more than just a background, and if you're lucky, some chests and those kind of vines there. But well, I'm sure you don't go in the ocean somewhere out there and find a cave that goes down to a treasure. I will see it like this. But I kind of like the ocean background and underground. Also, the new corals look or water deco. Well, it was a nice experience. Also, like the new items, like the kites to use in a windy day. That's a kind of cool gimmick, like the unicorn on a stick. I mean, you can just do it if you're bored or waiting for something, or if you just want to do something. Just something funny. Yeah, you can just use it. You can just use them and have fun with it. There are a few ones. Also, like the new NPCs, the dog. Well, the three animal NPCs are just there to keep full NPC rooms up. Also, the pylons work. It's really a bit annoying to set up the NPCs there to get the pylons, but once you get it, you just have to keep them somehow alive, and it works, and it's a really cool mechanic to get. And yeah, I really like the pylons to move around the world. Then there are some other things, like I think there were furniture of the fragments or some of the new critters. I don't understand the point of the like Amethyst bunny or Ruby Skrull, because they seem just so useless. I mean, they spawn on the ground like those gem trees. The gem trees, by the way, really cool idea. Looks really nice, and it's always nice to get some extra gems, but the gem critters, I don't see the point about them. They seem so useless. They don't have really a use. They just there, look strange a bit, but well, I'm okay with it. I really like the new mushroom biomes, they're really nice. Also, the new desert undergrounds, I kinda like what they did to the desert undergrounds. It looks like more life now, but at the same time, it's way more dangerous than just the worm. I mean, you could always get some good stuff there when you start the game, but now it's harder to find. You have to dig down. There are those cactus boulders, that's really deadly, and those larva critters, lots larva enemies there. Yeah, it looks kind of more alive. It's also more dangerous, so you have to work a bit more for getting stuff from there. I kind of like it. Well, I think I'm kind of at the end. There are a lot of few things too, but kind of forgot. Also, we tried out at the end the new star cannon. Still wanna Google it when you can get it, but I really like it. And yeah, so that's kind of the talk about my 1.4 master mode experience or other 1.4 things. Overall, I really like the update. Kind of said it's the last one, kind of the last one for Terraria, but I really like the updates. Great work there. And yeah, that's all I have to say about it for now. I still keep playing 1.0 modded Terraria, but at the same time I kinda can't wait to get 1.4 T-Mod loader, so we can play mods at 1.4. The only thing that really annoyed me a bit was that you have to, that they moved shift to STRG to quick sell quick trash, and it was kind of confusing when you switch between 1.35 T-Mod loader and not vanilla 1.4. I still don't understand why it was changed and why you can not change it back by yourself if you want to. But well, I think we get used to it once it's normal. And yeah, so that's it for this video. Hope you enjoyed. Maybe you can tell me in the comments what you think about Master Mode or 1.4. It's in my opinion a really good update. Really cool challenge. You can try once or multiple times if you enjoy. I did not really enjoy playing it at some points, and in my opinion, it's just way a bit hard to enjoy it multiple times. So I think I stick with Expert or Revengeance for Calamity or for other game modes, some other difficulties, but I think I stay with Experts. And yeah, so that's it for this video. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video and see you next time. Bye.